What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 60 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Heart Gold. Brand new day. We're up bright and early, and we're going to make our way north towards the next town, which is Saffron City. Right away, we pick up a TM for Silver Wind. It's a bug-type move. Unfortunately, I don't think any of my guys can use it. More new battle music as we start venturing into Kanto. And we got a new Pokemon, Cherubi. I know this is part grass. Actually, it's all grass. One EV point special attack. We'll go down easily to a flamethrower. I don't even know why you even bother to challenge me. Alright, we've already done one Pokemon battle. We're not even a minute in. Though I do see a double battle looming on the horizon. First, I'm going to take this girl on. Alright, what you got for me? Oh, you're a dude. I'm sorry. I called you a girl. Slack off. Another Hoenn Pokemon. Actually, a pretty strong Pokemon. It is a normal type. It's 180 point in HP. But it's got a really bad special ability called Truant. Only lets it attack every other turn. Alright, now let's do this double battle. Usually when I do double battles, I usually pair up Gyarados and Pidgeot. Danny and Day. Let's see who they got for us here. Flusel and Minun. More Hoenn Pokemon. You usually find these two in a pair. Both of them are electric, both worth one EV point in speed. And their respective special abilities are plus and minus. Basically, their powers increase when their counterpart is on the field. Actually survived a Hyper Beam? Not gonna survive an Earthquake, though. I guess I really didn't do a real good of a job with Pidgeot at his special attack. Focusing more on physical attack when I was trading him. And this is the underground path that'll take us under Saffron and into Cerulean City. We'll go there later. Yeah, I believe the routes now are going to get a lot shorter. All the I lost my train of thought here. All the routes are a bit more bunched together. And I think once we get a new video card, we can start a radio card. Give me a break, I just woke up. I believe when you get a new radio card, you'll then start to be able to catch some Hoenn and Sinnoh Pokemon. Not just here, but in the Johto region as well. Let's see if I can get some new Pokemon to come up here. New wild Pokemon music. Magnemite. These guys are only level 15. So apparently, the Pokemon reflect the levels that were in the original Red and Blue. They're not uber leveled like level 40 or 50. Yep. Beating up fresh baby Pokemon, so to speak. Is there anything new here? So far, no. That smoke ball is letting Espeon run from any battle, though. I don't think we really even need it. These Pokemon are so weak. Bellsprout. Again, nothing new here. Honestly, these guys aren't even worth fighting for experience. Maybe there's something new in the water. Anything? Psyduck. Well, this has been a bit of a letdown. I was hoping to see some new guys, but I think I can't really take advantage of it until I get the new radio card. Anyway, this little gate will take us into Saffron City. You remember the Magnetrain Goldenrod? This will be where it eventually takes you, right to Saffron City. Now, this is a big city. There's a lot to explore here. There is a gym here, the Psychic-type gym. Always a challenging gym. We're probably going to do that in the next episode. So I'm basically going to spend the remainder of this episode exploring Saffron City. And I'm just going to look around and just do that. Cruise through this little by little here. Yeah, unfortunately, we can't do the magnet train. This is Mr. Psychic's house, and I believe this guy's got a gift for us in the form of TM29, which is the ever dangerous psychic attack. And you know who's gonna get that right here, right now. I think it would learn Psychic on its own later on, but not at a much, much higher level. Right now, Espeon is the only one of my Pokemon that can use Psychic. I'm going to get rid of Swift. I'm hoping this move does not bite me later on. The Psychic is a pretty accurate move. Now, Espeon's got a little extra firepower. Yeah, he knows what I'm thinking. I just turned you into a bona fide killing machine. This is Silphco, one of the bigger dungeons in the original Red and Blue. There's not really much going on there. Well, why don't we go ahead and get our picture taken? That looks like a pretty decent photo. Bigger guys were in the back. Okay. And we got the upgrade. Now, I do believe this is strictly for evolving the Pokemon Porygon, an extremely rare normal type. Can't really do anything here, so we're just going to leave. We're going to visit the copycat girl now, because I do believe she will give us something later on. I think after we clear the power plant. That's the Pokemon Blissey, the evolved form of Chansey. Probably ranks highest of all Pokemon in terms of HP. I'm talking to myself all of a sudden. That's a real Binette. That's Cherum. Nosepass. I guess we'll come back later after the Magnetrain's back in service. This is, well, that is the Magnetrain line. For a quick zip back to Goldenrod and vice versa. Thank you. I'm also wondering when I get the next radio card. Yeah, this town actually has two gyms. The one gym was a fighting gym in the original Red and Blue. If you clear the gym, you don't get a badge, but you get a Pokemon of either Hitmonlee or Hitmonchan. Now, you can simply catch Tyrogue and get to evolve into one of those. I'm probably going to need to really stock up here, so I'm going to go ahead and buy some more medicine here. And since I'm probably seeing some weaker Pokemon, I'm probably getting myself some newer Pokeballs here. A couple downgrades even. Some Pokeballs and Great Balls, now that I got the money to do so. In case I run into anything strong or weak that I want to add to the Pokedex. Never have too much of these. You have anything special? Dust Balls, Quick Balls. Might as well grab a few of these while I'm here. I have been recording a lot of episodes at night, so they may come in handy. I just burned through my entire bankroll there. Now, to show you the fighting gym first. Nobody really is in it, nothing to do here. Later on, when you beat the game, you'll start seeing gym leaders and other trainers come in here. You can then battle them for experience. But at this point, I'm going to go ahead and call it quits. Next episode, we're going to take on the Saffron Gym. So until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.